This is the scene on a gloriously sunlit afternoon at Horse Guards Parade, where we're about to witness an extraordinary celebration for an extraordinary woman. From the length and breadth of this land, thousands of people have come to pay tribute to the Queen Mother and to wish her a very happy 100th birthday. Among them, her military regiments in Britain and the Commonwealth, and people from hundreds of her charities and voluntary organisations. And here too, of course, are members of the royal family. A very good afternoon to you and welcome to ITV's exclusive coverage of the Queen Mother's birthday pageant. In just a few minutes, the Queen Mother will arrive here for a unique celebration. Because of all the events to mark her birthday, this is unquestionably the People's Day. A day of ceremony, certainly, but one too of great informality, a carnival of fun. And in the true spirit we've come to associate with the Queen Mother, today's event is going ahead despite bomb threats and disruption to public transport. With me on the programme, John Suchet will help guide us through today's proceedings. Kirsty Young will talk to a variety of people who are taking part in the pageant today, and I'll be joined here in the studio by the royal biographer, Robert Lacey, and the actress and writer Nanette Newman, who's known the Queen Mother for many years now. Nearly 7,000 people will take part in today's pageant. There'll be a memorial flypast, the release of 100 doves and 1 million rose petals, and of course, all the magnificence of the massed bands, pipes and drums. And that's not all. There'll be the military march past, followed by the 100 years parade, a civilian march past of charities and organizations, a specially written birthday song and the presentation of a giant birthday card. And the Queen Mother herself is expected to make a short speech. That's what we're expecting. Now, a brief preview from our guest here in the studio, Robert Lacey. We said that this is indisputably a people's event, and there is some significance in that in itself.
Yes, because the monarchy is a popular institution. Here we are, we're looking at this wonderful parade ground where, of course, her daughter, the Queen, has her official birthday, and we've got all the troops lined up there. But it's shortly to be invaded by this motley army of civilians who all have their own association with the Queen Mother.
Nanette, what's the affinity, what's the secret of the affinity between the Queen Mother and the public? What's this great secret?
Well, I think they recognise a very strong, intelligent, up-to-date woman who has really a great sense of humour, and also she has a great appreciation and enthusiasm for life, and that's very appealing, I think.
Indeed. Well, thanks to you both. We'll be talking to you later during the event, but I'm told the Queen Mother is only a few minutes away now, so let's join John Suchet.
And what a perfect view of the London skyline to begin with. You know, Big Ben in the middle there, and coming in on the left of your screen, the London Eye moving imperceptibly. And below, Horse Guards Parade, the largest open space in London, and all bathed in the late afternoon sunlight of a perfect English summer's day. As the crowd applaud the Royal Philharmonic Orchestra, we hear the buglers of the Royal Marines. Medieval sound echoing across the parade, announcing the arrival of the Queen Mother. The escort of the household cavalry preparing the way for her. She'll be in a carriage accompanied, we believe, by her eldest grandson, Prince Charles. And we hear the parade commander in the background bring the parade to order. Colonel Toby Brown, here he is, commander of the household cavalry. And also silver stick in waiting. A largely ceremonial role now, but once upon a time, bodyguard to the sovereign. And in a second, he, Colonel Brown, will order the parade to present arms, and we'll hear the royal salute, the national anthem, being played as the Queen Mother enters Horse Guards Parade. And there's a story behind that. She was going to enter it to music from the Royal Philharmonic and then stand for the national anthem, but they said that's too dangerous in a carriage, And she said, I'm not sitting down, I'm not breaking with precedent, although she was told Queen Victoria once did it. And here she comes. Don't compare me with Queen Victoria, she apparently said. And we'll hear the huge roar from the crowd as she enters the parade ground. Magnificent view from our camera high above the parade ground as the Queen Mother makes her first appearance. And as soon as she enters the arena, Colonel Brown will bring the parade order and we'll hear the national anthem as the Queen Mother's carriage keeps moving. Brown will now tell the Queen Mother that her regiments are ready for her inspection.
Up! Arms! Shoulder! Arms!
This role, carried out 10 years ago on the Queen Mother's 90th birthday, by the then Commander of the Household Cavalry, Colonel Andrew Parker Bowles, a name that lives on today in connection with the Royal Family. And Colonel Brown, today's commander, escorts the carriage as the Queen Mother inspects her troops, something she's no stranger to. She first inspected her first regiment in December 1927. That's 73 years ago, and that's only the first of many large numbers you're going to hear today, as really you have to keep pinching yourself to realise that she is just 2 weeks off her 100th birthday. Music being played is I Was Glad by Sir Hubert Parry, which was played at the Queen Mother's own coronation. The Queen Mother's always had a soft spot for the armed services. She first came to know them during the Great War, the 1914-18 war, when her family home, Glamis Castle in Scotland, was turned into a convalescent home for soldiers. And she looked after them. She knitted for them, we're told. And she had an autograph book, and one of the soldiers she cared for wrote in her autograph book, may you be hung, drawn and quartered. Hung with diamonds, drawn in a coach and four, and quartered in the best house in the land. Well, you got all that right. Did W.H. Harrop of the 8th Seaforth Highlanders. Navy on the left there, with which so many of the royal family are associated. Prince Charles is a rear admiral. Queen Anne is a rear admiral. Prince Andrew was actually a serving officer in the Navy. Queen Mother had three brothers in the Black Watch, one brother in the Royal Scots. So you could say all her life, one way and another, she's been associated with the military. And yet, we're told, she has never once worn military uniform. This was deliberate even in the Second World War. She deliberately didn't wear military uniform because she wanted to set Britain apart from the militarism of Germany, which maybe is why Hitler said of her at the time, she is the most dangerous woman in Europe. know you want to know about those horses, so let me tell you, they're both grey geldings, one Irish, one Hanoverian. One's called Auckland, the other Twilight. I've no idea which is which, I'm afraid, but I do know that head coachman Colin Henderson is driving them, and he's wearing semi-state livery. I wonder when he wears full-state livery. Let's listen for a moment to Hubert Parry's I Was Glad, with the rousing cries of Vivat Regina, Long Live the Queen. Soon we'll see all those regiments formally marching past her for the military part of this great pageant. A pageant tells the story, and the story today is the life of the Queen Mother as told by her military and by the civilian organisations with which she's connected. We're looking now at military order and precision that will soon end when the civilians take over. Lieutenant Colonel Richard Waterer, there he is in command of all the military bands. He's a trombonist, by the way. Well, I wanted to mention that we trombonists must stick together. Paul Scott of St. Paul's Cathedral, conducting 1,000 voices from around the country. Brown again.
Parade, we'll move to the right. Right, turn.
And now the military are lining up for the march past, and here comes the Queen Mother. My goodness, this walk won't be worrying her. She walked the length of St. Paul's Cathedral last week, not to mention down all the steps outside the cathedral. But actually it's difficult, because what she's walking on underneath that red carpet is an industrial kind of sand that has been laid on this huge parade, inches deep, which only the animals love. It's a nightmare to march on. As you can see, it's not easy to walk on. She negotiated that faultlessly, to the huge appreciation of the crowd. Behind her in the plumed hat, Major General Evelyn Webb Carter, her host for the day, and William de Rouet, who is an equerry, and of course her eldest grandson. And to the music of the regimental marches, the military parade will begin.
Parade, well, march past, and quick
Royal Navy leading as the senior service, HMS Dryad this, a colour party, not a ship, but a school, a naval school outside Portsmouth. Here's HMS Ark Royal. The Queen Mother has a special relationship with this great aircraft carrier. The current one is being refitted. It's the fifth to bear the name. She launched it in Scotland in 1981. I know that. I was there and I covered it as an ITN reporter. And here she is standing. We knew this was going to happen. All her advisors said, ma'am, you really don't have to stand. Please remain seated for the parade. But no, she had to stand. Queen's Dragoon Guards, followed by the Queen's Royal Hussars. And in a moment, the 9th, 12th Lancers. And you'll be able to identify them because of their poles. I'll tell you about them in a second. Irish Guards marching past there. She has a special relationship with them. She presents the shamrock to them every year. She also goes to the sergeant's mess, I'm told, of the Irish Guards, where she's very partial to a black velvet. Champagne and stout, for those of you who don't know, or cider and stout if you can't afford the champagne. They call her your man Queen Mum. She calls them the mix. I'm told that on reliable authority. King's Regiment, Royal Anglian Regiment, the Light Infantry. She's Colonel in Chief, or otherwise, of 19 regiments in all, British and Commonwealth. Black Watch, almost her family regiment. Her brother Fergus, who was killed at the Battle of Loos in 1915, was a member of the Black Watch. Indeed, after her own husband's death in 1952, her first public engagement was to see the Black Watch off to Korea. The Royal Army Medical Corps, led by Lieutenant Colonel Sue Wesson. Women's Royal Army Corps now, and it actually officially no longer exists, as the women have been absorbed into the army itself. And indeed, their commander said to us today, don't call us rats, it sounds so ugly, and she's right. And now the Commonwealth Regiments. By the way, have you ever wondered why it's the Royal Air Force, which we're seeing now, the Royal Navy, but not the Royal Army? Well, it dates back to the Civil War, when the Army fought against King Charles I. Now, the Australians in their famous slouch hats, the Royal Australian Army Medical Corps. Canadians. We'll see New Zealanders as well today. Toronto Scottish there. They're instantly recognisable buff kilts, no tartans on their kilts. The New Zealanders. And lastly, three regiments from South Africa. You'll see them in a second. The Cape Town Highlanders, the Transvaal Scottish, and the Witwatersrand Rifles. Now, the Queen Mother was Colonel-in-Chief of all three until 1961, when South Africa was expelled from the Commonwealth because of apartheid. And, of course, they're back now. And at the end of last year, they wrote to her staff here in London and said, please, may we be on the parade ground for the 100th birthday celebrations. She said, of course they can. And here they are, marching in London for the first time for, what, 40 years. And here come the King's Troop, Royal Horse Artillery, carrying their guns, all of which saw service in the First World War. And the Queen Mother will no doubt remember the day in 1947 when her husband went to dinner in the regimental mess, and afterwards he signed the regimental book and he crossed out the words Riding Troop and wrote above the words Riding Troop, he wrote King's Troop. And so they have been ever since. When the king died, they wrote to the queen and said, may we please keep the name? And she said yes. And here they come, the most senior regiment in the army, when they are on parade with their guns. And guns are in fact their colours. Sound of the Royal Artillery slow march. For this, he's been planning this event for 6 months. And as the bands play on for the moment, back to Trevor briefly in the studio.
John, thank you very much. Back here in the studio, Robert Lacey, those pictures are quite magnificent. Do you see that magnificent? Did you see that moment there when the Queen Mother was asked whether she was all right? And she says, yes, I'm all right, quite all right standing. There's almost a Victorian image about what we are seeing here of this parade so far.
Yes, there is. In that carriage she came in just as Queen Victoria rode to her jubilees over 100 years ago. And, of course, we're right in the headquarters of the London District of the Army. There in the background, the Duke of Wellington's own office, where he used to look out on this parade.
And Nanette, the threat to today's ceremony, the disruption from threats of bombs and actual bombs, perhaps, I mean, there was no way, it was inconceivable that anything else but the decision to carry on with this
ceremony. Yes, it's very typical of her, isn't it, that she wouldn't want to disappoint
all these
people.
And there she is, still
people.
Standing.
Doesn't she look magnificent?
Absolutely wonderful.
Absolutely amazing.
But you were saying that there was no question that it would be
cancelled. No, because she wouldn't want to disappoint all these people, and it's very much in the spirit that she had during the Second World War, that in spite of everything, life has to go on.
And that's very much the spirit that the Queen Mother, Robert, has come to evince for all the people of this country.
I'm sure as people watch her now, there are many older viewers who will just look back to that, and of course younger viewers know it from television and photographs as well.
Indeed. Well, for the time being, Robert and Nenet, thank you very much indeed. Now back to you, John.
We're seeing the mounted bands and escort of the household cavalry. To the sound of the lifeguards and the blues and roars. And look at those horses. I can tell you they are Constantine. And there is another one there, I promise you, called Janus. And those are solid silver kettle drums that they're carrying, each weighing 80 pounds. Horses are now the last of the military horses to leave the parade because, believe me, there's some chaos to come, and the word was get all the animals off, because once the military procession is over, we really don't know what's going to happen. Though they look great with the sunlight reflecting off their uniforms. And very soon we're going to see the first of those other occasions with the release of 100 doves. But first the army have to be ordered off the parade ground. And here The doves are being prepared for release, in fact, before the armed services.
Your Majesty,
come off.
I present you with your first gift for today, 100 white doves.
That is Dominic Kramer, 12 years of age, who is about to sing O for the Wings of a Dove by Mendelssohn, of course. Nine doves being released. Dominic will release the 100th, and there they are. I'm told that they're going to regroup in the skies above Horse Guards and fly back to their roost in Essex. They will do it. They're under military orders. In fact, they've been crossed with white racing pigeons to make sure they do. And they better watch out for the flypast that's due in a few minutes. And in the meantime, as the military precision ends, we begin the civilian element now with a cavalcade for a century. The procession of 100 years, each group representing one decade of the century. There's the first decade, in which the Queen Mother, of course, was born, 1900, Captain Hook from Peter Pan, and Kirsty in the crowd.
Well, from the Queen Mum to the Queen Vic and another very well-known Windsor, thanks for joining us, because I know you're in the parade.
It's a pleasure.
It's been quite a day for you today. Tell us what you've been doing this morning.
Well, this morning I received an MBE for the Queen. I'm so thrilled. Thank you very much. So I'm meeting two queens in one day. That's fantastic.
And you're going to be taking part in the parade.
You bet. But what are we standing in, Kirsty? Yeah. Have you seen all the
horses have been here. Thank you for taking the time.
Pleasure. Have
Good
a great
in the
one.
Parade.
God bless.
Thanks very much.
All
Barbara
right,
Windsor, MBE.
And here the parade of a century continues. Stream Guard in the middle there. There are just 100 of them who have been ordered to keep control of the civilians. I think they're being very well behaved. Marching past the Queen Mother, they've all been told to smile and wave at her. That's showing the discovery of Tutankhamun's tomb by Howard Carter. World War One in the second decade of the century, which is when, as I said, the Queen Mother first came to know the military up in Scotland. But the emphasis today is not so much on war as the end of war. Ballroom dancing, which we're told she's very partial to. The 1930s, which of course the Queen Mother began simply as the Duchess of York and ended as Queen of a Country at War. And Bill Pertwee, I think, from Dad's Army, apparently one of the Queen Mother's favourite television programmes. Wonderful. Wonder if that stupid boy Pike is there somewhere. Probably in there wearing one of those hats. Background, a fire engine and an ambulance from the war years. I think if I'm right, the Queen, when she was Princess Elizabeth, actually drove an ambulance during the Second World War. I'm not entirely sure about that, but I think she did. And you can see in the background there the dancing, which we'll see a little bit closer in a moment, to celebrate the end of the war. And the Pearly Kings and Queens apparently made their first appearance in the 40s after the war. The music in the background, by the way, is a selection of popular tunes from the last 10 decades arranged by Mick Dowrick of the Royal Marines School of Music. Here we are, celebrating the end of the war. Hope the Queen Mother realises that's why they're dancing. I'm sure she does. Yeah, she loves it. Queen of Blyton's famous noddy made his first appearance in the 50s. Also a sad decade for the Queen Mother. She must be remembering that in 1952 her husband died and her daughter became Queen. Hillary's ascent of Mount Everest. Not quite sure what the Russian representatives are doing. As I said, it's a bit chaotic down there. Great musical. And the first Mini. This is the very first Mini, I'm told, that rolled off the production line in 1969. The original Morris Mini Minor, that was. Jitterbugs. 50s. I think we're in the era of James Bond now. That looks like an Aston Martin to me, and Bond girls on either side of it, if I'm not much mistaken, slinking past the Queen Mother. Don't know who the James Bond is there. That, by the way, is a Formula One Aston Martin Lagonda, it says here. Now, the 1960s, it said if you can remember them, you weren't there. I can remember them. An MG Roadster, famous sports car of the era. Signalers there are actually wishing the Queen Mother happy birthday with their flags. The era of punk. Don't know quite what the Queen Mother makes of that, but there you are. Hell's Angels. Must be the first time a bunch of Hell's Angels have driven past the Queen Mother. Not the first time that the police have there. Just moved on in time before the E-Type struck them from behind. Great sports car, the E-Type Jaguar. And I can tell you that children inside, the young boys and girls inside the Wombles uniforms are not cold at the moment. I saw them at 10 o'clock this morning at rehearsal. They were already baking. You can imagine how hot it is inside there now. Well, the Queen Mother must have her Wombles, and here they are, suffering for her. This, I'm told, is Alice in Computerland. I suppose computers and .com and www had to get some mention today. Sir Norman Wisdom, great to see him. I wonder if he'll do a crack ball for her. And a Diana Dawes look-alike there waving for the Queen Mother. Celebrating, of course, the British film industry, those great days of Ealing comedies, the Carry On films. We saw Barbara Windsor earlier. Great favourite with the crowd, Sir Norman Wisdom, made the Queen laugh when he got his knighthood as he tripped up on the way, walking away from her. Now we're in the 90s, that's a Eurotunnel going past. Well, that was the decade that Tunnel Under the Channel opened. First thought of over 100 years before, finally made it then. How could we now live without it? They'll remember this day for a long time, won't they? she was asking. Maybe it was that that she was seeing. Well, I'm afraid I can't actually enlighten her. But here's the dome. Here's a young lad dressed as the dome. Well, maybe he'll be more popular than the real thing. He got the short straw today. The parade of the centuries shortly coming to a close. But believe me, there's a lot more to come. Finally, Britain's global village. Everyone saluting the Queen Mother, and in a moment there'll be an explosion of noise and colour as everyone salutes, calls out happy birthday in Asian, Caribbean, Irish, English, Scottish, Welsh and Far Eastern, and dance for her.
Led off by Her Majesty's corgis, Rush and Minnie.
Now here are the Queen Mother's corgis, as you probably heard. William Tallon. He's the page of the back stairs at Clarence House. Actually, I'm told he runs the place. He's leading the Queen Mother's corgis, Rush and Minnie. Hope they don't make a leap for her as they recognise her. I'm told that it's said of William Tallon that it's no use putting a hand over the glass. He pours the drink through your fingers. And the corgis, by the way, I'm told, are very sweet-natured. Upset them and they'll have your ankle off. Horses now, very close to the Queen Mother's heart. There's an orchid is in there somewhere, the great grey. There he comes. And walking with him is Tim Greet, the vet who saved his life when he removed a length of intestine from Desert Orchid. I don't think many people knew that. Now, this is where we really can't predict what's going to happen, as over 170 of the Queen Mother's 350 or so charities all take part in this great parade. Somewhere down there, I can tell you, is the Salmon and Trout Fishing Association. It's said that once the Queen Mother was fishing in a boat on the River Dee, and a lady-in-waiting was fishing in the middle of the river, saw her, immediately curtsied, her wade was filled with water, and she had to be dragged off the bottom of the river. So it's said the Queen Mother didn't mind a bit. Now there are some excited people waiting to take part. Kirsty.
Yeah, we're just about to go on to the parade ground, or this group of people are here. They're from the Girls' Brigade, the biggest contingent, 260 of them. This is a very special one, because she just last year got a great award. Tell me about your award.
I got my Queen's Award, which is the highest award you can get in Girls' Brigade.
And what about today? What do you make of the festivities so far?
It's excellent. There's hundreds of people here. Everyone's, like, really looking forward to it.
We just on the parade ground. I'll let you go.
Also somewhere down there is the Overseas Nursing Association. And I mentioned them because they phoned us up the other day and they said, we weren't mentioned 10 years ago, please mention us today. And may I say we've mentioned them, but there are going to be a lot of charities today that we're not going to be able to mention. All I can say is come back in 10 years' time for the 110th and we'll try and mention you then. 100 chefs representing the biggest culinary association in Britain, the Cookery and Food Association. 100 chefs removing their tocks, I think they're called. Friends of the elderly, for which no doubt the Queen Mother has a soft spot. Difficult to believe, seeing her standing there waving to them all that she is 2 weeks off her 100th birthday. Saw as part of the Girls' Brigade of England and Wales, and you'll recognise the music in the background. Keep the home fires burning, great war songs. Is Daniele Gatti conducting the Royal Philharmonic Orchestra, but let's go down to Kirsty in the crowd.
Oh, hi there, I'm with a lot of giggling little girls who are pretending they don't want to speak to me, but I know they do. What are you dressed as?
An army nurse.
An army nurse, it's a beautiful uniform. Who made that for you?
A lady in Anita.
She did a very good job on it. And this hat is fabulous. You're dressed as, you a maid?
Yeah.
And who are you marching for today on the parade ground?
GFS in Atherston. GFS in Atherston.
Are you having good fun?
Yeah.
You're about to go onto the parade ground now. I'll let you go. Have a great day.
Now, this is the Mothers' Union with their giant mother there. She looks a bit frightening to me. And I can tell you that there's a bit of a jam occurring here, which is only to be expected. But as they come onto the parade ground, there's a sergeant major down there telling them, keep marching, 120 paces to the minute. I doubt they're taking much notice of that. There's a Coldstream guard trying to keep order. And Colonel Mike Parker, you can just see behind the Queen Mother there, said to them at the rehearsal, keep moving, we don't want the Queen Mother to be 101 by the time you've finished. Now the AA were personally invited here by the Queen Mother. Because they were formed at about the same time she was born, right at the beginning of the century. And I'm reliably informed the Queen Mother can't drive. Certainly she's never been seen to drive on a public road. And apparently doesn't hold a license. But she invited the AA to be here today. And there's an old-style AA man in the front. I remember when they used to salute when they saw the badges on the front of cars. And the modern equivalent just behind him, which we're more used to seeing today. People in this parade, and you can get a feeling for that just by looking at them there. The keynote of all this is fun. The idea was this wouldn't be a solemn celebration, it would be a great explosion of fun. They've been waiting for this for a long time, all of them. One other piece of advice Colonel Parker gave them was bring your sense of humour. I don't think he needed to tell them that. Princess Anne there on the left. Well, what's she making of it? In front of her, Princess Margaret. She looks a bit bemused, Princess Anne, doesn't she? I think the ones that are stuck in front of the Queen Mother stand are loving it. They'll dine out on this. And in a few moments, all heads are going to crane upwards as there's going to be quite a spectacular flypast. Not quite there yet, just about half a minute or so. And here is the Poultry Club of Great Britain. I'm told the Queen used to keep a flock of chickens as a child at St Paul's, Waldenbury in Hertfordshire. And there are two young girls who are either about to or have just given the Queen Mother a basket full of eggs for a nice omelette tonight. And the flypast is coming by any moment now. As we watch the lifeboat, Royal National Lifeboat Institute there. But let's crane our eyes upwards. There we are at our first sight of the Lancaster bomber in the middle with a Spitfire on either side, and we have a camera inside the Lancaster. This is the view from the skies. just flown over. There are more to come, more aircraft to come. As we're watching, there it is again, the Poultry Club. I'm glad they're getting two mentions today. Poultry Club of Great Britain, of which the Queen Mother is patron. Now, coming up is a real treat for aircraft spotters. That is a Bristol Blenheim, and it's the only one of its kind still flying anywhere in the world. At the outbreak of the Second World War, there were 1,000 of them in the RAF. Today, just that one. And in about half a minute's time, the Red Arrows are going to fly over. I think I read somewhere that "The Nightingale Sang in Berkeley Square" is the Queen Mother's own personal favourite song. And here come the Red Arrows. And there are 10 of them. Normally there are 9. But 10 today to represent each of them a decade of the Queen Mother's life. Some more familiar faces about to go on the parade. And let's hand over to Kirsty down in the crowd.
Well, you're saying familiar face. I've got a very familiar and very beautiful face with me. It's Jerry Hall, looking absolutely splendid. Can you tell me a bit about what you're wearing, Jerry?
I'm Flora, Queen of the Flower Fairies.
Splendid. Who's your friend?
Donald Standen.
Oh, are you having a nice time?
Yes, thank you.
Well, thank you for taking part. You look fantastic.
And we'll see them on the parade in a moment. The Royal Box, the Duke of York on the right with her two daughters, and on the left the Speaker of the House of Commons, who's just stunned politicians by announcing she's retiring at the end of the current Parliament, Betty Boothroyd. I know she hates to be reminded she was once a Tiller girl, but, well, you've got to, haven't you? And talking of Tiller girls, well, not quite, the Royal Academy of Dramatic Art, RADA, now marching past with the Middle Temple, accompanied by the Middle, not actors in wigs, but the Middle Temple, barristers of the Middle Temple, judges even, accompanying the future generation of actors and actresses. I do believe this is the National Trust, these young girls representing the National Trust, or if not that, one of the gardening organisations, one of the many gardening organisations that the Queen Mother is close to. She does love gardening and has had a number of flowers, I know, dedicated to her, named after her. Now, here's a bull. We've had corgis, we've had horses. We've now got a bull, an Aberdeen Angus bull, with two Cheviot sheep accompanying him. And this represents the Royal Smithfield Show, and she's patron of that. Indeed, it's one of her favourite annual visits, and she is a breeder of Aberdeen Angus herself. I'm told she takes a close interest in farm animals, especially pedigree bulls. And in This, with the Royal Smithfield Show, is a 1914 tractor behind there, but in front, a modern tractor from the year 2000, the horse-drawn tractor from 1914 behind. And here is Jerry Hall, as we saw now, representing Flora, the goddess of gardens. And doesn't she look the part? Oh, no. I'm a bit stunned for words here. These are maidens in cockle shells, representing the National Trust, I'm told. Mermaids with King Canute behind them. He's got the best job of the day. These are the mermen supposed to be accompanying those mermaids. Ah, now I've been waiting to tell you about the Hastings Winkle Club, founded in 1900 in the old town of Hastings, but with a serious objective to raise funds to provide a happy time at Christmas for the poor children of the town. And it's said that members who do not produce their winkle when challenged have to pay a fine. And I'm sure there's a better way of putting that. They have winkle eating contests to raise money, and the Queen Mother is an honorary member of the Winkle Club, as is the Prince of Wales, or as was the Prince of Wales, who became Edward VIII, as was Field Marshal Lord Montgomery, as was Sir Winston Churchill and Prince Philip. And the leader of that delegation told us there wouldn't actually be any real winkles on display today. They tend to smell of it. Wonderful costumes going past the Queen Mother now. I think I saw the actress Susan Hampshire at the front there. But for the moment, let's hand back to Trevor in the studio.
Thank you, John. Robert Lacey, I suppose after the military precision of the regimental march past, this is a kind of loosely choreographed chaos, really, isn't it?
Yes, it has all the charm, I think, of a county show, and the sort of thing that the Queen Mother would have been very familiar with.
A sort of student rag day.
And a student rag day as well, yes. This is, of course, all these good people's tributes.
These are the St. John Ambulance Brigade.
Well, you see, there's a fine example of the voluntary strand in British life, which is out here on parade in full force, paying tribute to her. But of course also the tribute is to them as well, and all the people who make this sort of thing possible.
And I saw somebody from the Red Cross this morning as I was coming in who said to me, the Queen Mother has been associated with the Red Cross for 73 years,
yes,
Nanette.
That really
and
is
that's
amazing,
an indication of what today is really all about, isn't
yes,
it?
Yes, and of course she likes to be involved with all the charities, not just a figurehead, a name on a piece of paper. She likes to know exactly what is going on. And the other thing, Trevor, isn't it lovely to see so many children involved in
yes.
today's parade?
She's waving to them there now.
Absolutely.
Look at yes, absolutely.
And you know, she has a great affinity with children, and I believe sometime later there's going to be a performance from the Chicken Shed.
Yes,
company.
I know you're looking forward to seeing that.
I'm looking forward to seeing that. This is so exciting, isn't it?
It is. Robert, you would agree, there's the Royal School of Needlework, and that's another one of the associations with which the Queen Mother is associated.
Over 320, isn't it? And, of course, this has been going on since 1923. She took on her first Nurses Association, and it's grown ever since.
Well, let's go back now, for the time being, to Johnson.
And the Queen Mother, on parade for almost an hour now, at 100 years of age, with Major General Evelyn Webb Carter on her left, as I said earlier, is her host. He's the Major General commanding London District and in charge of events today. And he said earlier to the military, this is a unique opportunity for us to salute and recognise this amazing lady's achievement of living to 100 years. But so are the civilian charities. Pretty proud of it too. To the tune of Charlie is my darling. Well, there he is, right on cue. Ambulances of St. John's, one of the largest delegations on parade today, over 250 members in all. It's the leading first aid care charity in Britain. It also has 53,000 volunteers under the age of 18. And they're actually on duty here today as well as parading, as they are at all major events. You'll have seen them even in theatres in the West End, everywhere. Voluntary people caring for those who fall ill. Suddenly and unexpectedly at public events. Well, I hope no one's feeling the heat out there today, but believe me, it is like a cauldron out there, despite the fact the sun is beginning to drop a little. Even arranged the shape of this parade so the sun wouldn't be in the Queen Mother's eye by 6 o'clock in the evening. The National Society for the Protection of Cruelty to Children, she's a great supporter of that. It is too 100 years old, same age as her. Children dressed up in costume, 20 children taking part in a themed float of the NSPCC, and they'll remember this for a long time. So down there, in fact, is the Marie Curie Cancer Care Society, and as they go past, the Queen Mother will no doubt remember her husband who died of lung cancer. But let's go down to Kirsty, who's got some rather unusual guests. Kirsty.
Now, we've got all creatures great and small here today. Tell me about the camels. Why the camels?
It's something to do with the grocer. The grocer something.
How far have the camels come from?
The other side of Oxford.
Oh, so not from Egypt then?
Yeah.
You're heading into the parade ground, I'll let you go.
Well, maybe I can tell you a bit more about the camels than he can. We'll see them in a minute. They actually represent the worshipful company of grocers, and the crest on their crest bears a camel, which harks back to the worshipful company of grocers' origins in the Middle Ages as merchants and wholesalers of spices, gold, and exotic goods from the East. We'll see them on parade in a moment. This man is very proud. Every rose he's carrying, he has bred personally for the Queen Mother. And here are the camels, six of them in all, as I said, from the worshipful company of grocers. And in fact, they're almost at the end of the parade. Remember, there were horses at the front. And when those with the horses heard there were going to be camels on parade, they said, keep those camels as far away from the horses as you can, which is why the horses were at the front of the parade and the camels almost at the back of the parade. He's not happy that camel. It's taking a lot to control him. Uh-oh. Well, we warned you anything might happen this afternoon. No, he's up again. He knew he had to. Did he get the hump, one wonders? Maybe it was a bow, who knows? Oh, God. Sitting between the humps. He almost regretted that for a moment, but he just got away with it. Maybe it's a... I'm told the Duke of Kent, well, the Duchess of Kent, certainly amused. Prince Michael of Kent there, and Princess Michael of Kent, of course. Sorry about that. They really can't believe what's unfolding, I think, in front of their eyes. to dress up. Well, if she's feeling the heat a little, who can blame her? As I said, it really is warm in this cauldron of a parade ground, with 21,500 people taking part. This is the Royal Commonwealth Society, with 54 flag bearers in national dress. Commonwealth, something that the Royal Family have always felt very, very strongly about. Queen Mother actually's been patron of it since 1936. She and her husband used to give a cheque for £100, once gave a cheque for £100, until I'm reading this, which the society used to buy a clock for their entrance hall, and it's still there. Now, the old boys of the Second World War, several organisations we're going to see. Friends of the Imperial War Museum are the first in that old Second World War open truck. She once asks them, she in fact regularly asks them to call on her at Clarence House. And we're going to see several more, a proud old soldier. We're going to see several more organisations from the Second World War. They always wear bowler hats on parade, these veterans of the Second World War. This is the Royal British Legion Women's Section, which is founded to look after widows and their children and ex-service women. 200 walkers today, with National Standard Bearer, who in the front is a young girl from the Isle of Man, but behind her 200 standard bearers in the Royal British Legion Women's Section. All the civilians now forming up on the parade ground, filling it, perhaps as it's never quite been filled before. As I said, between 5,000 and 7,000 members of the civilian parade, 12,500 in the stands, not to mention 1,000 military. In all, around 21,000 people crowded into Horse Guards Parade this afternoon. In fact, there was some fear early on that they wouldn't all get on. They have. The Colditz Association, here we are, riding in old cars. Most of their members are over 80, so they ask to be seated. They're in three taxis. There are 6 members of them only left today. Very proud organisation. And you can tell how much the Queen Mother feels for the old boys of the Second World War. You'll see the Battle of Britain Fighter Association. That's the Battle of Britain Fighter Association and Bomber Command Association, including men and women from the flying and ground crews that served with Bomber Command. 55,000 air crew died during the Second World War. These are 50 men and women representing all members of Bomber Command: pilots, navigators, wireless operators, bomb aimers, engineers, and flying and ground crews. Proud men and women. The old vintage bus there, which no doubt the Queen Mother will have known when it was once running in the streets of London. And now bringing up the rear of the parade, members of the Victoria Cross, Order of the Victoria Cross and the George Cross, the highest medal that can be awarded in war and in peace. They're getting a standing ovation from the crowd. 22 of them are on parade today. Those who have been awarded either a VC in war or a George Cross in peace. And my God, they're standing for her, that's lovely. Everyone is standing, even the royal family in the box are honouring these men. The last surviving holders of the Victoria Cross. And they're in vintage Rolls Royces, 12 Rolls Royces in all. That's a great moment.
There are 21 members with us today.
And the last car in the parade, sitting in the back there, furthest away, is Sir Ronnie Flanagan, the Royal Ulster Constabulary, representing the RUC, which was itself awarded collectively the George Cross in April this year. That's a proud lady, but I think these are pretty proud members of the parade. Now, to the tune of the Boys of the Old Brigade, another proud lot, Chelsea pensioners. Marching slowly, they're all over 65 and single, and either on a military or disability pension, those are the three conditions. As I say, they're all over 65 years of age, and yet the Queen Mother can give them all a clean pair of heels. She's older than all of them. That's Brigadier Kim Ross, the adjutant of the brigade. Now she's got to her feet in honour of them. There are 373 residents of Chelsea Hospital, most of them fought in World War II, covering every theatre of war. They've won every campaign medal issued from the First World War up to and including the Falklands campaign. Doesn't Queen Margaret like it? And from the old to the young. See, running out from the behind the royal box, members of the Chicken Shed Theatre Company. Because it was founded in a chicken shed 26 years ago. Children who are going to sing and dance an original song called The Next 100 Years, written by Joe Collins, one of the co-founders of Chicken Shed, with lyrics by Paul Morrill. It's going to look back on the Queen Mother's past 100 years and look forward to the future.
Yeah.
Shed, many of whom weren't born at the Queen Mother's 90th celebration 10 years ago in this very arena. And it's said that only a love of the performing arts is the only requirement to join them, which may be why there's a waiting list of 2,500 for 1,000 places. And from the voices of children now to the huge sound of every musician on the parade ground, orchestra, choir, massed bands, pipes and drums, singing a special song, 100 years, composed specially for her by Barry Hingley, who is Principal Director of Music at her parade now.
Thank you. That was a special birthday song for the tribute, composed by Barry Hingley and entitled 100 Years.
And now, as he did 10 years ago, the well-known actor Sir John Mills, a personal friend of the Queen Mother's, 92 years of age himself, is going to make a short address to her, standing in the back of an original 1907 Rolls-Royce Silver Cloud.
Your Majesty, 10 years ago, you expressed the wish that for your 90th birthday, there would be no fuss. On that occasion, I'm afraid, we didn't altogether obey you. So for this even more special birthday, we planned to invite only those who were determined to be present to express their love and their loyalty. Unfortunately, ma'am, as you may have noticed, there were rather a lot of them. So here we all are again, dear ma'am, to say thank you for everything you have meant to the people of this nation and the Commonwealth, for your lifetime of care, hardship, and inspiration to those who are here now and to those who have gone before. And on their behalf, to wish you, with all our love, a very, very happy birthday. Oh, and to offer you this small and very understated birthday cake. Happy birthday, ma'am.
Sir John Mills, no doubt, looking forward to being here in 10 years' time to do the same for the third time. And here comes the cake, and in fact, I can tell you, this is a bit less of a cake than it was supposed to be.
Come on!
That is Ross Molloy, aged 6, the little chef. And here come the crumblets. It was supposed to be, actually, it was supposed to be an inflatable cake. You may have seen it on the news bulletins last night, but in rehearsal, it didn't inflate. So they've done away with the cake, but they've kept the crumblets, and they've kept the candles, and here they come. 30 children from Vauxhall School, surrounding it to make the frill inside the crumblets. And in a moment, the little chef, Ross, will ask the Queen Mother to blow out the candles, and she'll ask him to do it for her.
Would you like to blow out the candles on your birthday cake, or shall I do it for you?
Ross Molloy, didn't he do well? And stand by for an amazing sight. You're about to see a million rose petals as the dancers come onto the parade ground. I mentioned them earlier. Irish, Welsh, ethnic dancers, as a million rose petals fall onto horse guards. The organisers here, I spoke to them, what do you fear most, rain, cold? No, they said wind. And there is no wind today, and so the rose petals are dropping perfectly. Personally counted by 65-year-old Ken Grapes of the Royal National Rose Society, and they fell perfectly. And we're about to see the biggest birthday card you've ever seen.
Majesty,
because it contains no fewer.
Now I send you with your last gift of the day.
A big card signed by everyone at the parade.
Which means 8,000 signatures. She's going to need a mantelpiece and a half for that one. Going to do it now.
That'll be very precious. Thank you. Very much. You all done this. Yes, thank you. Isn't that a lovely present? Thank you. Very much. And I have to say my thank you. I would just like to say a heartfelt thank you to all those who come from far and near to take part in this lovely brigade. It's been a great joy to be. And the martyrs, the children, my regiments, especially the music, and the excellent musicians, have been a wonderful joy to hear. I do hope you've all enjoyed it as much as I have. It's been a wonderful evening. And I'll just say, God bless you all, and thank you.
In the parade, Donald Sinden, the actor there, Sir Donald Sinden, clearly moved. And the parade will end officially as it began, with the military, and three cheers for the Queen Mother.
Thank you.
to mention that the signing choir that you saw there briefly during the national anthem was the Royal School for Deaf Children, Margate. Wonderful establishment that I'm myself involved with. And now the Queen Mother will take her place in her Rolls Royce, I believe, not her carriage now, for a lap of honour before she leaves the parade ground. Once again, I'm told that she was advised not to try the steps. We can make other arrangements, ma'am. Not a bit of it, she said. I'll do it, and she has. It really is hot out there, and she's been on parade herself now for just about an hour and a half at the age of 100 years, less 2 weeks. Quite an achievement. No accident that Prince Charles has been at her side throughout. And as she takes her lap of honour, let's reflect as the band play "Here's a Health Unto Her Majesty," and indeed they're going to follow it with an equally suitable song, "Will Ye No Come Back Again." But let's reflect that she is indeed the only member of the British royal family in British history to reach 100 years. She's been an active member of the royal family for 77 years, since she married Prince Albert, later King George VI. And she has been queen for 63 of those 77 years. Shortly after her husband died, she issued a statement in which she said, "Throughout our married life, we have tried, the King and I, to fulfill with all our hearts and all our strength the great task of service that was laid upon us. My only wish now is that I may be allowed to continue the work we sought to do together." And she's done it for half a century since. Ground to the bagpipes, "Will Ye No Come Back Again." What is she thinking of? Well, my guess is she's thinking of the next great royal event. 2 years from now, in the summer of the year 2002, the Queen's Golden Jubilee. It's said that she aimed to make it to 100, come hell or high water, and I would guess that her aim now is to make it to her daughter's Golden Jubilee.
Back here in the studio, is about to ask you what would she have made of it all, but she told us she enjoyed it. Mm-hmm.
She did, yes. It's wonderful to see a heroine celebrated, isn't it? In the last few weeks, all these documentaries and profiles probing her, and you wonder what it's about, and you see it on an event like this. It's heroism celebrated.
Indeed. And Nanette, in a way, all her life and her career has been an antidote to the kind of cynicism which we see so common these days.
Oh, yes, and I think in a very cynical world, nobody could doubt that this has been a marvellous party, and it's given masses of people the opportunity to say to the Queen Mother, we're very glad you've been with us for so many years.
And the organisers would have done well, Robert, haven't they?
They have. That last shot of her going through all those placards of those different organisations who got inspiration from her, it seems to sum up the whole day.
Yeah, I think she'll take home the knowledge that all of those tributes came from the heart.
Indeed.
I think she'll enjoy that.
Thank you very much. We're taking a short break now. When we come back, we'll have all the day's national and international news and the weather. And if you just missed it, we'll bring you the highlights of today's pageant for the Queen Mother's 100th birthday parade at Horse Guards Parade here. Join us in a couple of minutes. Not very long ago, the Queen Mother left for a reception at St. James's Palace. But for more than an hour today, she was honoured by a thoroughly public tribute. There were representatives from her military regiments and from her numerous charities. And at the end of it all, this is what the Queen Mother had to say.
It has been a great joy to be. And the marchers, the children, my regiments, especially the music and the excellent musicians, have been a wonderful joy to hear. I do hope you've all enjoyed it as much as I have. It's been a wonderful evening. And I'll just say, God bless you all, and thank you.
The Queen Mother speaking at the end of her birthday pageant. And I'll be returning later with a full summary of today's events here at Horse Guards. But first, the news.
Sheds, many of whom weren't born at the Queen Mother's 90th celebration 10 years ago in this very arena. And it's said that only a love of the performing arts is the only requirement to join them, which may be what is a waiting list of 2,500 for 1,000 places. And from the voices of children now to the huge sound of every musician on the parade ground, orchestra, choir, massed bands, pipes and drums, singing a special song, 100 years, composed specially for her by Barry Hingley, who is Principal Director of Music at her parade now.
Suchet there, taking us through the first part of the Queen Mother's birthday pageant. There's more to come after the break, including this. The moment this young chef blew out the candles on the Queen Mother's special cake. Join us again in a couple of minutes.
Take this new high-performance Astra Coupe, load it up with an average family, and the handling will suffer. To prove this, I'll be mother, and my colleagues here will be my husband and children. As you can see, the car is now unresponsive.
No, it isn't.
Thanks to the enhanced chassis and uprated springs and dampers,
and the lowered sports suspension, and...
Quiet in the back!
Don't cheek your mother.
Vauxhall, raising the standard.
I've been
Thank you. We don't need discounts to bring low prices. We got low prices every day. Like this Beach Effect laminate flooring.
It's easy to lay and B&Q's got everything you need to do the job.
And at B&Q it's only £4.78 a square metre. All this flooring for under £120. That's the everyday B&Q price, not a sale price.
You can do it when you B&Q it.
Hello, oh yeah, yeah, it's me. Have you stopped this thing? Yeah, I'm not sure it speaks English actually. No, I've tried Rowan here. Yeah. Rowan isn't doing the job, to be honest. Could you stop laughing, Phil? Should I actually that funny? Whoa!
1-to-1, the pay-as-you-go phone you can use abroad.
Time for a chat every Thursday.
At B&Q, this set of low voltage lights is only £9.97. That's the everyday B&Q price, not a sale price. You can do it when you B&Q it.
Discover Margaret Astor, wow. New 60-second Wonderlast. A nail polish that dries incredibly fast and lasts perfectly for a long time, even if you reach for the stars. New 60-second Wonderlast, only by Margaret Astor. Colour your emotion.
Watch out for the new Andrex Puppy Pal Pouch. Get yours for £4.99 and tokens from special Andrex packs. But hurry, they're going fast.
So you had a choice. An anti-aging cream for lines and wrinkles, or one for all seven signs of aging.
When Boots asked you to vote for your favourite anti-aging cream, you chose Total Effects, recommended by Vogue and proven to reduce the appearance of the seven signs of aging.
Not difficult, was it?
Total Effects from Olay.
That bootiful Bernard Matthews turkey leg roasts down to 99 pence in Farmfoods, the frozen food specialists.
At B&Q, this 12-volt cordless drill kit is only £19.98. That's the everyday B&Q price, not a sale price.
Welcome back to Horse Guards Parade, which earlier this evening was the sunlit backdrop for the Queen Mother's birthday pageant. Before the break, the march pasts and the parades had ended, and as we discover, the best was yet to come. So let's return now to the excitement of the occasion, at the point where a theatrical knight and the friend of the Queen Mother pays the nation's tribute. Let's go back to John Suchet.
And now, as he did 10 years ago, the well-known actor Sir John Mills, a personal friend of the Queen Mother's, 92 years of age himself, is going to make a short address to her, standing in the back of an original 1907 Rolls-Royce Silver Cloud.
Your Majesty, 10 years ago, you expressed the wish that for your 90th birthday, there would be no fuss. So here we all are again, dear man, to say thank you for everything you have meant to the people of this nation and the Commonwealth. For your lifetime of care, hardship, hard luck, and inspiration to those who are here now and to those who have gone before. And on their behalf, to wish you, with all our love, a very, very happy birthday. Oh, and to offer you this small and very understated birthday cake. Happy birthday, man.
That is Ross Molloy, aged 6, the little chef. And here come the crumblets. It was supposed to be, actually, it was supposed to be an inflatable cake. You may have seen it on the news bulletins last night, but in rehearsal, it didn't inflate. So they've done away with the cake, but they've kept the crumblets and they've kept the candles. And here they come, 30 children from Vauxhall School. surrounding it to make the frill inside the crumlets. And in a moment, the little chef, Ross, will ask the Queen Mother to blow out the candles, and she'll ask him to do it for her.
Ma'am, would you like to blow out the candles on your birthday cake, or shall I do it for you?
Here, I spoke to them. What do you fear most, rain, cold? No, they said wind. There is no wind today, and so the rose petals are dropping perfectly. Personally counted by 65-year-old Ken Grapes of the Royal National Rose Society, and they fell perfectly.
Your Majesty, now I present you with your last gift of the day. A big card signed by everyone at the parade.
Which means 8,000 signatures. She's going to need a mantelpiece and a half for that one.
I would just like to say a heartfelt thank you to all those who come from far and near to take part in this lovely brigade. It's been a great joy to be. And the marchers, the children, my regiments, especially the music, and the excellent musicians, have been a wonderful joy to hear. I do hope you've all enjoyed it as much as I have. It's been a wonderful evening. And I'll just say, God bless you all, and thank you. They're going to follow it with an equally suitable song, Will Ye No Come Back Again. But let's reflect that she is indeed the only member of the British royal family in British history to reach 100 years. She's been an active member of the royal family for 77 years since she married Prince Albert, later King George VI. And she has been queen for 63 of those 77 years.
Shortly after her husband died, she issued a statement in which she said, "Throughout our married life, we have tried, the King and I, to fulfill with all our hearts and all our strength the great task of service that was laid upon us. My only wish now is that I may be allowed to continue the work we sought to do together." And she's done it for half a century since.
John Suchet, rounding off our highlights of the Queen Mother's birthday pageant. It was, as we have seen, a party for the people, not just for those taking part, but for those watching too. Kirsty Young talked to some of them to find out what they thought of the Queen Mother's special day.
Ladies and gentlemen, can we ask you please start moving into your seats? Downing Street to your right, the South Stand, North Stand and Admiralty Stand straight on. Thank you.
The audience taking their seats were looking forward to an afternoon of ceremony, but also great informality and fun. Over 7,000 people took part in today's parade, including some of the century's most enduring entertainers. Barbara Windsor arrived after a memorable morning.
Well, this morning I received an MBE for the Queen. I'm so thrilled. Thank you very much. So I'm meeting two queens in one day. That's fantastic.
And you're going to be taking part in the parade?
You bet.
Today was a day for young and old, and moved many.
I've never been in anything like it. So much affection, so well directed. Wasn't it beautiful? Makes you proud to be British.
Waving goodbye after her tribute on the parade ground, Dame Vera Lynn.
So many people from so many parts. It was absolutely wonderful. The greatest tribute ever.
To people who are watching at home on TV, how would you describe the atmosphere of today generally?
It was really warm, really loving, really excited. I felt that everyone that was there wanted to be there to say to her how much they loved her. It was great.
Sir John Mills found reading the birthday address nerve-wracking.
We wanted to say how much we loved her, how much she'd inspired us, what she'd done for us all these years, and wish her a happy birthday.
One of the touching things about this afternoon's celebration were the sheer numbers of the general public paying tribute.
A lot of hard work all through the day, and you get very hot wearing all this gear, but it was worth it. It was a really enjoyable experience.
There were young people here, there were old people here, but it was absolutely lovely.
Great, yeah!
Good experience.
Today was a wonderful mixture of the military and the civilian. In a sense, really, the ultimate classless society, because everybody of every age, of every group, everyone who'd had anything to do with the Queen Mother, almost past and future, were gathered together, and amongst, above everything, it was great fun.
And the fun doesn't stop here. The celebrations continue until August the 4th, the Queen Mother's actual birthday.
Kirsty Young there on what those watching thought of today's pageant. And that brings us to the end of our programme. It was a day of fun and informality, just as the organisers had promised. As we saw, the Queen Mother called it a wonderful evening. And so it was. She said she hoped everyone had enjoyed it, and we hope that you at home did too. So let's leave you now with a look at some of the more memorable moments of her special day. From Horse Guards Parade in London, good night.
The big news is they've got a new nurse at the centre. Took them long enough.
A time for new beginnings.
Yeah, I think I'm going to like it here.
We should do this more often.
Can we keep this between ourselves?
Of course, yeah. You're not worried, are you? About fitting in?
No. Lucy's in trouble, isn't she?
I think you both are.
Where the Heart Is, Sunday at 8 on ITV.
Collect orders.
Febreze antibacterial cleans them away to keep your home harmonious.
Unforgettable.
Campino.
That's what you are. Unforgettable. Though near or far.
Campino. Small, like a smooth, of love and unashamedly good. Clings to me.
The way things go, you get so low, struggle to find your skin. Oh, hey ho, look out below, your prayers will never be answered again.
My bank is so enormous, it's streamlining branches for my benefit and convenience.
My bank's intensive management realignment program means I never see the same business manager twice.
My bank will now be charging monthly fees on arranged overdrafts.
My bank's just launched FiveBacon.com, a completely separate e-banking account.
Oh dear, my bank is now a trendy wine bar.